I thought I'd make a video showing you how I put together my most recent comic. I've made a comic about Nosferatu, the classic of German expressionist cinema of the 1920s, my favourite genre. It's not. My favourite genre is 1950s Japanese home dramas. But anyway, today my favourite film is Nosferatu, and I decided that I would make a lino cut of the to act as the cover of each comic. So I've transferred my cover design onto a piece of soft cut lino here, and I'm just cutting away all the areas of the design that I want to appear as white on the final cover. I'm working with a material called soft cut, which is a lot softer than regular lino, but I don't know, I've not worked with lino since I was at school, and I don't remember it being this difficult. It took me a lot longer than I thought it would. I've had to fast forward this video 5,000% because it took me hours and hours and hours to finish the design. But one thing that I also noticed is that after about 15 minutes of cutting, my wrist felt fine as I was cutting, but then when I stopped and I sort of rotated my fist, my wrist felt like someone had smacked it with a mallet. Absolutely wrecked. So I don't know, if you work with lino on a regular basis, then please tell me how you prevent your wrist snapping off at the hinge. I had to take breaks every quarter of an hour and put frozen peas on my arm to prevent it from exploding. Anyway, enough of my pain and misery. Yeah, so I'm cutting this away. The reason I decided to make a comic about Nosferatu is because I really enjoy the film, but I think there's just a few things about it that don't work to a modern audience. So if I was in the cutting room with Murnau today, there are some things that I'd say you can probably leave on the cutting room floor. Like, for example, the character of the professor, who's the equivalent of Van Helsing in the Dracula book. He's got a lot of screen time, but he's got no impact on the plot at all. So I just thought it'd be better if he was ditched entirely. And then there's just some other things that I've always found a bit comical about Nosferatu. For example, Orlok, there's a scene where Orlok carries his coffin on his shoulders through the streets of Germany, and it just looks a bit daft. So I've cut out things like that, or I've sort of reframed them and just re-edited them. Anyway, now what I'm doing is spreading this calico ink onto a piece of glass and rolling it out nice and thinly with this brayer. Is it called a brayer? The roller, anyway. And I'm putting the ink onto the lino, and now I'm printing it onto this piece of card. I've already printed the inside cover on a laser printer, so I'm just putting the lino design on the outside cover. A few days later, the lino prints are dry. It takes a lot longer for this ink to dry than you would expect. Anyway, so 3 days later it's dry, and I can spray on this red ink, which is supposed to be the blood on Orlok's coat. And now what I'm doing is I'm putting an acetate cover on the comic to protect the lino, but I've also got a second layer of acetate on here as a guide so I can see where to punch these holes through the entire comic. So the entire comic now is assembled, and now I'm going to sew it together. Sometimes you see hand-stitched comics or other books, and there's maybe like three or four holes punched in the comic, and which is fine, but I sort of think after all the effort you've gone to of making the thing, it just looks a lot better if you've got maybe like 25 holes punched in the back. So it doesn't take much more time, so that's what I've done here. And now all I've got to do is fold the comic over, which is quite difficult once you've got an acetate cover on it. Acetate doesn't fold that easily, but once you've folded that over, you can start cutting it. You can start cutting it, I could start cutting it, right? So I'll cut the comic by hand here. No way I was going to get a guillotine through all that. It's like 52 pages or something. So anyway, I've made 15 copies of this comic. I can't really make more than that because it takes ages. It takes ages. So if you would like a copy, then you've got to snap them up quick, right? Because there's only 15 I'm going to make. This is copy number 5. They're all numbered. So if you want a copy, go to my Etsy store, link below, and snap one up. Thanks.